Hi, this is the first of two tutorials that look at the customer profitability whale curve from two different perspectives. In this first curve, I want to point out that the whale curve has a blind spot. When you look across the broad back of the whale, we have lots of basically break-even customers, plus or minus a little bit. You don't know the size of those customers. They could be huge, and it's just huge margin is offset by huge cost to serve, and it's a zero account. But most of them are going to be small. What we do know is that at the front end of the whale, the head of the whale, the number one customer can only be there because they are huge, very large. You see down here at the huge dollars we're talking about, huge margin dollars, and cost of service big, but noticeably less, and the difference, of course, is profit. At the bottom of the port, you also will find customers that are very large. Their sales are enormous. Their margin dollars are enormous. Their margin percent can even be pretty good. It's just their cost to serve is way higher than the gross margin dollars, so you have a loss. So in distribution businesses, the leverage, of course, comes with the big accounts. Conversely, if you had tiny little accounts and they gave you one order for the year and you lost $15 on it, it doesn't show up. It's on the broad back of the whale. And so you'll find that most of the accounts that are along the broad back of the whale tend to be very small little guys. The ones that start to slope down in the back of the whale can be here. They can be a little bit bigger, but still small. Once in a while, you will find a big potential whale that just randomly bought something from us at one time, and we have to figure out how we're going to find those guys and cull them out to give them full service model treatment, as opposed to all these guys need to be reassigned to a different division that's got a different service model that allows us to have at least have the chance to make a profit on them. Thank you.